Well, God bless you and welcome to Jerusalem. We are here at the day of prayer for the peace of Jerusalem.
And so with much love, and as a member of the priestly family of Aaron, allow me, please, to bestow upon you the priestly benediction which was given here in the Holy Temple thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago. Remember, here in Jerusalem, Abraham, 3,500 years ago, was ready to sacrifice his beloved son. Here, 2,000 years ago, Jesus the Jew was crucified in this city. We don't have to beg to be here. We have the right to host all nations here and to teach our message of peace. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, who has commanded us with thy commandments. And with the sanctity of Aaron, to bless all of you with love. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and grant you and the entire world the peace of Jerusalem forevermore.
I'd like to welcome up Mrs. Goldie Sternbach. She is the Director of International Relations for Mayor Panim, who is our partner here in this great work. If you'll come, Goldie. We want to make a presentation this afternoon on behalf of Eagle's Wings as a demonstration of the ongoing support that Christians have around the world. And Wendy, if you'll come now with that. We want to bring up to Jerusalem, every time the pilgrims came to Jerusalem, they came and they brought a gift. It wasn't enough to bring their songs. It wasn't enough to bring their expressions of worship. They needed to bring up an offering to Hashem. And so we want to bring up an offering to present to Jerusalem. And we do that through the feeding centers that we have in Jerusalem and in Tiberias. So on behalf of Eagle's Wings and on behalf of Christians around the world, here is our donation this month of $15,000 to strengthen the feeding centers and to continue to feed all of those who are needy in Israel. God bless you. David, you helped begin this journey with us. Give us a quick comment before we give this to our brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah. There we go. I know an Orthodox Jew shouldn't be saying that.
David is a David's a Pentecostal Orthodox.
Blessings, everyone. Blessings. Blessings.
Furthermore, in recognition of God's faithfulness to the seed of Abraham, their matchless contribution to humanity, and the plight they have experienced through the ages, I commit myself, in the spirit of the Hebrew scriptures and the prophets, as a disciple of Jesus Christ, to raise my voice for the sake of Zion until Jerusalem becomes a praise in the earth.
And from this stage, I want to say to your churches which are filled to the rafters, that anybody who denies the Jews the right to live in the land of Israel is not only anti-Zionist, they're anti-Christian. They are anti-Christian because anybody who says that Jesus, who was born just over this hill in Bethlehem and baptized near Jericho, would be today an illegal settler. By the way, according to that definition, Mary and Joseph were illegal settlers. But you know that Jesus, who lived in Judea, never heard the word Palestine, which was coined by the Romans a century after his death, And no doubt Jesus himself would be appalled by the mere suggestion that Jews, Yehudim, could not live in Yehuda, Judea. And any church that remains silent in the face of Palestinian denials that the temple existing is condoning the denial of the existence of the temple in which Jesus taught. Temple denial, quite simply, is gospel denial.
Let's once again thank Ambassador Michael Oren for these incredible, inspiring words. Well, we come now to the last portion of our program, which is the place where we step more fully into the place of prayer. And we encourage those of you watching around the world on television right now through the wonderful ministry of GODTV. We thank you, GODTV, for your constant commitment to Jerusalem, to Israel, to the Jewish people. We encourage you all around the world to join in with us now in prayer. And just a quick word for our Israeli guests, because in a moment, let me explain what's going to happen. There's going to be a lot of singing. There's going to be a lot of clapping. There may even be some dancing. And for those of you who think our Israeli guests, this is a little unusual, a little different. We just say right back to you, we got this all from you folks, all right? It's all, we got it all from the Psalms. It's all from you. What I want to encourage you to do is to not hold back. You've come a long way. You've paid a lot of money to be here. You wanted to be a part of this special gathering. This is the moment to not be a spectator. This is the moment to not simply fill a seat. This is a moment to, in earnestness, in reality, engage our hearts with the divine presence, engage our hearts with Hashem, and to offer up prayers on behalf of Yerushalayim.
We, representing believers from the north, the nations to the north, the nations to the south, the nations to the east, and the nations to the west of you, we say over Jerusalem, Holy Spirit, breath of God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe into these slain that they may live. Breathe hope today. Breathe hope today. New hope, new hope, new courage, new strength, new life. Breathe into these bones today. We proclaim over these bones your promise in Jeremiah 29, verses 11 through 13. I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Then you will call upon me, and you will come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And we say today, out of the ashes of war, out of the ashes of suffering in this city, in this land, in this region, let new little trees, new little seedlings come forth, a young generation that will arise with hope and with faith in the Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we pray this, Lord, as we pray as Christians, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Today I want to pray that this great highway that is being built between Israel and the nations of Asia will be complete in our time, and that God will raise up tremendous support, tremendous strength for Israel, for Jerusalem, from the nations to our east. Would you join me in this word of prayer? Lord, I pray that the nations of the Far East will rise up in support of Israel and pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Lord, you know that the front door of our nation has biblically faced to the east. The tabernacle in the wilderness, later the great temple here in Jerusalem, always faced to the rising of the sun. Jesus entered this city to shouts of Hosanna through the eastern gate. Ezekiel's prophecy proclaims that the glory of God, the God of Israel, came into the house through the gate facing to the east. Lord, even our national anthem says that the eyes of the Jewish people look eastward for the hope of Israel. Lord, today I pray, and those here with me, we pray
that you raise up a mighty army.
Yes.
Of believers in Korea, in China, in Singapore, in Taiwan, in Malaysia, Indonesia, Australia, and so many other nations to our east. Lord, these nations that you are raising up today in our generation with power, with economic might and political influence, we pray you will build this highway of sympathy, this highway of support, and this highway of prayer. We pray you'll raise up this army of believers to our east who will have a revelation of Israel's importance to them, and they will have hearts on fire to stand and pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Lord, we say once again, bring your wise men from the east who will again herald the coming of the Messiah. Lord, we pray this and we thank you for doing this in our day. We pray in his mighty, mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit has gathered us together to pray for the peace of Jerusalem and for this nation. So let's praise and pray. He's enthroned in the praises yes. of his people. Lord, we are amazed. Thank you for penetrating our spirits with your goodness. Thank you for your holy calling upon our lives to be one with your purposes, to pray on behalf of the peace of Jerusalem. You are the resurrection and life. You have the power of your spirit. You have the glory of the Lord. We are asking, let it fall upon this city with all your goodness, with all your grace, with all your mercies, so that your will may be done here on earth. But we pray for the leadership of Jerusalem. We pray on behalf of the Prime Minister. We pray on behalf of the Cabinet. We pray on the leadership of the whole nation. Lord, we pray. Put your glory in the north with the borders in Lebanon. Put your glory in the south, in the west, and the east. Lord, we bless your people, holy people of Israel. Thank you for gathering them like a shepherd. Like a shepherd to reveal your goodness upon this city and through this city and through this nation to the rest of the world. We worship you, and I have prayed in the name of Jesus. Amen.